Hey everyone, I've been getting some comments asking me how I made my animated intro to my tutorials. So I thought I'll make a video of my process that walks you through the different programs and techniques that I use to make it. So this would be a great time to roll that intro. Before we get started, if you haven't checked out my channel, I make tutorials for Photoshop, After Effects, and Premiere. If you're new to those programs or you want to see some intermediate and advanced techniques, check out those videos and don't forget to subscribe and like. Now this project took me 5 to 6 hours from start to finish, and it spans 4 programs, Illustrator, Blender, After Effects, and Premiere. And it's a 5 to 6 second intro. And so that really puts into perspective the amount of work that goes into animating 1 second of fully custom content. And that should go into play when people ask you to make a quick 30-second animation for them. There's nothing quick about this. Now, I want to give a disclaimer up front. I'm going to be using 2 plugins throughout this tutorial. And I'm telling you this because I hated it when I was getting started and I was watching tutorials and they wouldn't tell me until halfway through the tutorial that they're using some $500 plugin. I was like, I don't have a $500 plugin. So you've been warned. Don't hate me when I start using plugins. But I'm using these plugins because they allow me to do things in After Effects that you otherwise cannot do, such as working with a 3D object file natively inside of After Effects. So if you're still with me and you're ready to move forward, then let's get started. Step 1, Adobe Illustrator. Now I had my original Allen Clock logo as a PNG, so I opened that up in Illustrator. I went to Window, down to Image Trace, and that opens up the Image Trace panel, to which I click Trace and convert it into a vector. Now it's time to export my SVG, File, Export, Export As. I tried this, changed the pull down to SVG, and it did literally nothing. I tried it 3 more times just to make sure that I wasn't crazy. I was not. So I go to File, Save As, change the pull down to SVG, clicked Save, and on to step 2, Blender. Now, truth be told, I don't do 3D. So I admired this pretty landing screen, recognizing that I'd never make anything as cool as this. So I closed the landing screen, and I admired this default cube long enough until it was time to say goodbye, click Delete, and it was time to import my SVG. File, Import, SVG. Spent about 3 minutes wondering why they put it over here. Spent about 3 more minutes trying to figure out where the move tool was so I could move it to rough center. Once I figured that out, I had to then erase these other aspects of the SVG, so I clicked on them and hit delete to make these little gaps. I was feeling pretty good once I figured this out, but it was still flat. So I go over to this little unassuming icon over here, toggle down geometry, and go to extrude. I used these little arrows to extrude to my desired thickness. Whoa, too thick. Dial it back. Now it was time to export my OBJ. File, export, wavefront.obj, export OBJ. Now the hard part is over. Step 3, After Effects. Now, because After Effects doesn't actually natively work with OBJ files, I'm going to be using the Video Copilot Element 3D plugin. To get started with Element 3D, you have to create a brand new solid, layer, new, solid. I name my solid, logo, and because the color doesn't matter, I like to make mine green. Apply the effect, effect, Video Copilot, Element. In your effect controls panel, click on Scene Setup. This opens up Element 3D. Time to import my OBJ, click on the import button, find my OBJ, and in the next dialog box, choose Use Auto Normals. Now when I imported this, nothing showed up. It's because I had to check the box that says Normalize Size, and then there it is. I played with different shaders and ultimately decided on the matte black shader. Everything else was good, so I hit OK. To make my logo appear normal, I'm going to toggle down the particle look, come down to the particle rotation, and rotate the X value to turn my logo on its proper face. Now to view this, I have to make a brand new camera. Layer, new, camera. I use a 2-node camera for this. So I click OK. Toggle down my 1-view pull-down to make this 2 views horizontal. In the left hand, I'm going to choose top. And now I have my camera. I can move my camera around and start to view my 3D logo now inside of my composition panel. To control my camera better, I make a brand new null object. Layer, new, null object. I name this camera controller. and then I parent the camera to my null object. I check the box to make my null object a 3D layer. To learn more about controlling cameras with null objects, check out my Understanding Null Objects tutorial. Now it's a matter of adding keyframes to my camera controller and the logo itself in the Element 3D plugin. Once I do this, it looks like the logo is now bouncing off the screen. Let's add some depth. Toggle down camera 1, toggle down camera options, and turn on the depth of field. Now you can change the aperture and the focal distance to allow the camera to blur in and out as the logo is flying in. To create smooth movement, I go ahead and adjust some of the timings in the graph editor. Time to add some lights. Layer, new, light. I like to use point lights because they're the easiest to wrap my mind around. I'm going to make this blue with an intensity of 12,000, and I hit OK. This now creates a light that I can click and drag around to interact with my 3D logo. After various experiments on lighting position, I decided on a total of 3 point lights, with keyframes applied to their position, their color, and their intensity. And this allowed for an active lighting system that interacts with my logo over time. Now it's time to create a 3D stroke. To start, I make a new shape layer. Layer, new, shape layer. And then I add a very simple blue stroke to this layer. Now I want to make this a 3D stroke, so I'm going to use the Red Giant plugin 3D Stroke. Effect, RG trap code, 3D Stroke. From here, I can adjust all sorts of parameters. I can choose the basic preset of circle, but the biggest thing here is to turn on taper, and taper allows it now to kind of give this thickness to the stroke itself. Using the transform pulldown, I can now rotate this on its x-axis, create a brand new track mat layer, layer new solid, apply a track mat, draw a mask on this to make it seem like the stroke is circling around the logo. To take this stroke a step further, I apply another plugin from Red Giant. Effect, Red Giant trap code, and I apply shine. Using the shine plugin allows me now to create this emanating light from that stroke itself, giving it some more texture. Now this was looking great, but it was lacking something. As it hit the screen with such force, it just felt a little too rigid to me. So in Element 3D, under the deform pulldown, you can enable deform. And this allows me now to bend and deform my logo with keyframeable properties. And so now when it hits the screen, I deform it and then have it flip over the other direction to kind of create this wobble. And this added some nice squishiness to the logo where previously it just felt way too hard. To wrap up, I added some pre-made elements to create some texture as the logo came in and out. Now it's time to add some text. Using a single text layer duplicated 3 times, I masked out each word, then added a track mat layer that allowed each masked part to come in individually. I then duplicated all of those text and track mat layers. I changed the color of the original text layers underneath and then staggered the keyframes to tie in with the rest of my color scheme. Once I was done inside of After Effects, I exported this using Adobe Media Encoder. But now that this is done, on to step 4, Adobe Premiere. Inside Premiere, I imported my rendered After Effects file, made a new sequence out of it, and then imported a bunch of sound effects that I had from my sound effects library. I also imported a music track courtesy of Artlist. Taking up as many audio tracks as I could, I added my whooshes, my swooshes, my swishes, and some textural atmospheres, and soon it was sounding pretty good. I mixed all the sound effects in the audio track mixer, and then I was ready to export. I used a pre-existing preset that I had made using the H.264 format, changed the bitrate up to 22, and hit Q. This queued it up in Adobe Media Encoder, clicked the green play button, let it export, and once it was done, I had a finished animated intro for my videos. Thanks for joining me on this whirlwind tour. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I hope to see you in another tutorial soon. Again, I'm Alan from It's Alan Time. Happy creating.